It is very important that we address this issue collectively. And I want to thank ICA and thank the Director General for his vision and foresight in bringing the ministers of agriculture from Latin America and the Caribbean together. With the consensus that we have seen thus far, we are better placed to, first of all, go back to our capitals, speak to the representatives who will be leaving our countries to go to COP, and place within the context of the general discussion the vital importance of agriculture. Going into COP this year, the difference is that from Latin America and the Caribbean, there is a high level of collectivism, and there is definitely a consensus as to what we wish to see as outcomes coming directly from the lips of the ministers of agriculture. The system is an integrated one. When a hurricane comes to an island, it devastates whatever is in its path. And within the context of my country, the Ministry of Sustainable Development is the ministry sees with the roles and responsibilities to represent the country as it pertains to international discussions regarding climate change. On my return to St. Vincent and the Grenadines, I will have a conversation with the Minister of Sustainable Development, and we will address that particular area that we'll carve out within the scope of the overall discussion for agriculture and fisheries. Food production, food security are two very important issues to the representatives here from the Caribbean, and I'm certain that it is the same throughout Latin America and the Caribbean. Food must always be accessible, available, and affordable. And coming out of the pandemic, the COVID-19 pandemic, and whilst we're grappling still with the resultant vagaries of the conflict between Russia and Ukraine, we definitely have to address issues of production and productivity. And we have to do it within the context that our climate is changing. We have a large percentage of our farmers being smallholders, an average 2 to 3 acres. And in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, in the Windward Islands, St. Lucia, Dominica, Grenada, we exported once to the United Kingdom under a trade preferential system. And that was removed, it's totally eroded. And because of the resultant implications of the banana case, there's now global competition. So we are now at a stage where we are working to establish a more diversified production platform. So on the one end, you have very small holdings, and now we do not have a single cash crop as a main crop. It's very diversified. What that means is that whenever you are planning and you're projecting for marketing purposes in order to obtain markets globally, you have micro production, and it creates complexities as it pertains to planning and the variations in microclimates within the country, and the entire issue of climate change makes the issue even harder to address, because you may be growing 16 different crops and they're all affected differently by the resultant implications of climate change. We have witnessed over the last 3 years one of the worst droughts in 50 years in my country. And it definitely impacted negatively on livestock production and productivity. We saw where some farmers were not able to continue in production until they received the support from the government, because there was no crop insurance. Because with a multiplicity of crops, it's more difficult to attract insurance. We have been able to work with several companies and agencies And we anticipate and expect that within the next year or so, we will have crop insurance, not only in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, but throughout the OECS. Definitely the synergies that we can have by operating on a multilateral platform far exceeds if you are addressing these issues in a singular way. ICA has created a platform for the last 8 years, and I want to congratulate the organization for its steadfastness. It has operated in a very resolute way. It has come to the rescue of many member states during times and periods of disasters. Within each country, there's a framework for support, and this support works alongside other organizations, other bilateral agreements and frameworks. And what we're doing this year in preparation for COP is that we are having a platform for discussion. At this platform, we were able to address some of the critical issues that are addressed in the agriculture sector. A single voice is going to be louder at COP this year for agriculture. And not only are we addressing critical issues of financing, how are we going to put the framework for implementation, the bureaucracy, the issue that working together we will be able to have better reported systems. All of these issues we have to address collectively. And this is coming against the backdrop and within the context that many of the countries in Latin America and the Caribbean have for decades been working very closely through the multilateral framework that has been established by ICA. And this is just another very important issue that we are addressing collectively. It was really heartwarming to sit with my colleagues throughout Latin America and the Caribbean and to address this issue. We have addressed issues of family farming, youth in agriculture, women in agriculture. How do we address irrigation and other technical support? The fact that we are here shows and it reflects that we are laying a platform and a significant foundation. I would anticipate that there's going to be a review by ICA post-COP. And at that point in time, we are going to do a reassessment. We are going to set up within ICA a framework for monitoring and also for support. Because within each member state, there are strengths and there are weaknesses. And that's one of the big issues why most persons will participate actively on a multilateral platform such as ICA, because we can support each other. So post this COP, I anticipate that we will be able to sit, we'll be able to reflect, and be able to prepare for the challenges of the future. We have to do this together, collectively.